What up? It's the Trooper. What's up, OJ? Thanks for getting the pops.
Thank you, Christina. Also true, out here hustling.
Yeah.
In the best city, if you love to gamble.
Yeah.
Hands down. Check it out. Can't beat it.
Can't beat it. You know how they say, nothing stops the gamble, right? You've heard that somewhere before? Well, nothing stops the sparkly pops. Have I said that before? I feel like I've said that before. You know what? Coming through. It's busy as hell on Fremont Street. I guess it's some Labor Day weekend action going. It's Sunday. There's all kind of like concert action and all kinds of shit going down here. I don't know what all is going on. I mean, look, it's 11 p.m., right? Had a super late start today. And I can't expect Pizza Rock to be open 24/7. All that being said, I'm not sure what could be more disappointing than standing in front of Pizza Rock and they're closed. Sigh. I mean, I sighed and I said sigh. It's like a double sigh.
When I sighed.
You sighed?
Yeah, I went.
You know, I have mentioned, I have spoken about many times actually in this vlog, especially lately, about my struggle with time management. Or just time in general. Sometimes it's not even really about managing time, it's just about time. Today, it was my intention to get an early start. Early, not a normal start, not an acceptable start, but an early start. Not only did I not get an early start, I didn't even get a normal or an acceptable start. I actually got maybe the latest start I've gotten in a long time. So I know the other day, you heard me say I don't like dried fruit in cookies, but these cranberry cookies from Crown Bakery, oh yeah. So it's 104 degrees out here. I think that calls for iced coffee. But then again, everything calls for iced coffee. So it's actually the next day now. Decided to do something we haven't done in a while. Q&A action. I asked Twitter, so let's see what they came up with. All right, Steven wants to know, is Resorts World your new favorite place for poker? That's a tough question. That's always been a tough question. People always ask me, Trooper, where's your favorite poker room? I usually say Golden Nugget for a bunch of different reasons. But lately, I've been in no mood for the Golden Nugget. I have to be in the mood for each place. I think my two favorite are Aria and Resorts World. They each have their own set of pros and cons. Aria is a little more in an area of the strip that I would rather be, as far as the vlog goes and stuff like that. Aria is around better food choices. Resorts World, I really don't like any food choices there, but Resorts World has a 24/7 Starbucks just a few steps from the poker room, and they actually do a really good job at that particular Starbucks. So a con about Resorts World is that the tables are small. They really are smaller than the rest of the poker rooms in Vegas, but I heard a rumor today, I don't know how true it is, but I heard a rumor today that they're about to go eight-handed at Resorts World. If they go eight-handed at Resorts World, for sure Resorts World would be my number one favorite. Shaft wants to know how many tablespoons of Go Gamble blend do I put for a cup. It depends on the size of the cup. When I use the 15-ounce mug and the extra large cup setting on the Ninja with the rich button, 3 tablespoons. Hope that's helpful. Might not be. Craig wants to know if I have Yo Troop, any plans for another Trooper Across America road trip on the vlog? Your road trips are always incredible. I appreciate that, Craig. I don't have any current plans. There are places that I want to go to, though, that I want to travel to, but we haven't nailed anything down yet. As far as Trooper Across America goes, Trooper Across America was fun. It was amazing. One of the things I wanted to achieve with Trooper Across America was a bit of a fail. But as far as the videos and the experience or whatever, I got really burnt out at the end and super tired for being on the road for a month. But I did love it. So who knows, maybe in the future. Dragon? Do you own any crypto and which ones? You know what, I dropped a few bucks into crypto several years ago, and I'm quite disappointed on part of it. First of all, I bought 5 Litecoin at 263. It's not a lot, that's what I did. And then I put $500 into Ripple, and I don't remember exactly how many Ripple, well, let's see. I'm pretty sure I bought it at 26 cents, and what would that be, around 2,000 Ripple, close to 2,000 Ripple? I might have bought exactly 2,000 Ripple. I put those Ripple in a Toast wallet, and then I made notes of all the numbers and passwords and all that shit that you have to do for Toast wallet. And then I changed phones, downloaded Toast wallet, tried to get into my Toast wallet, and couldn't. After weeks of trying to figure it out, I consider those Ripple lost. Pretty sure that Ripple, I don't know what it is today. Last time I checked, it was like 6 times that value. Who knows? Litecoin was at 263. I think it's at like 200 now. I don't even know. I'm just not really that into it, to be honest with you. Well, LTC is 219 right now. It's been as low as 35. So, as the kids say, hold. All right, this one's a little silly, actually. ST3 answer 20. Elevator union here. What is an elevator union? Are you telling me that people who work on elevators are in a union? Just a PSA that continually hitting the button beyond illumination doesn't send multiple requests to arrive or make it arrive any sooner. Any artistic gain is far outweighed by our maintenance concerns. Well, first of all, if you work for an elevator company in that you make repairs and charge for them, you should want maintenance concerns. Second of all, This is a troll from, not you, the elevator button thing is a troll from way back. You gotta go back and watch the vlogs from way back. I know it doesn't send multiple requests. I know. That's not a question though, but hey, why not? Nicole wants to know, if I absolutely had to move from Vegas, where would I move to? That's a tough question. Leaning towards Florida, but as I sit out here in this 104 right now, sweating balls, it makes me think about the humidity in South Florida, because if I went to Florida, it would be South Florida for sure. I don't know if I can handle the summers there. I really don't. Other than that, I do like it there. I enjoy the weather. There are a lot of things about Florida I like. I've never really considered Texas, but Texas would have to be on the list. And then pretty much anywhere cold that I want to move to, there would be too many. Well, I don't know about that. There might be some places that I would move to that are cold. I would prefer cold, but all right, Vegas to Cali. You want to know what is my exact order at Starbucks and how do I make iced coffee at home? Let's save the iced coffee at home for another time. Unless you have a Ninja machine, I don't know how to tell you to do it. I just figured out how to do it the way that I do it on the Ninja machine. It's funny that you asked, by the way. At Starbucks, my order was a grande iced coffee with 3 pumps of vanilla and 2% milk. So it's the menu item is technically called an iced coffee with milk. But the vanilla started tasting really weird, so I switched over to classic syrup, which is like an unflavored syrup. And now the classic syrup has started to taste really weird. So they have another thing now at Starbucks. I noticed on the app when you order, mobile order, it's called liquid sugar. I don't really know the difference, but next time I get an iced coffee, I'm gonna try that. But I used to get a grande with 3 pumps of whatever syrup and 2% milk, and then I would get it in a venti cup with extra ice. But most of the time, they assume I'm trying to get more coffee, so they make a bigger coffee in a venti cup. I'm not trying to get extra coffee. I'm not trying to save a few cents. I'm trying to get more ice, because the shit needs to be cold. Hidden Jackpots wants to know, my number one favorite Iron Maiden song of all time forevermore is Hallowed Be Thy Name. Live version, not the studio version. Did you see that? I'm sweating balls out here. The live version of Hallowed Be Thy Name, preferably from the Live After Death. There you have it. The Trooper might be second, but it's probably tied with like 18 other Maiden songs as my second favorite. All right, that's gonna do it for this edition of Q&A, which has been, I don't even know how long, months and months and months, if not years, since I did one. Maybe we'll have to do this more often. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button, make sure you subscribe, tell your friends about the videos, and leave a comment down below. I'm gonna see you next time.